All right.
NGA East, the goal is next generation attenuation model for Central Eastern U.S. NGA East, basically, the goal is to develop next generation ground motion prediction equation or attenuation model for Central Eastern U.S. Basically, as Steve mentions, the key sponsors are EPRI. NRC, we have a contract with NRC for now a couple of years. EPRI, we have a contract with EPRI right now. USGS is a key partner on technical issues as well as financial and manpower and everything. Department of Energy, we are working on the contract with Department of Energy. How the project started, basically, in 2007 and 2008, we had different workshops, invitational as well as public workshops. We got input from everyone who attended on the workshops. We compiled a list of the topics that we have to address in the next 5-6 years in this project. Through several iterations, we finalized the list. It's publicly available. It's list, is posted at peer website. One thing that immediately was clear is that we want to develop next generation attenuation models for Central Eastern U.S. We didn't want to go and use the existing model and just play with the weighting and so on. We just wanted to start from scratch and do the best that we can. There were several topics that came out of these workshops that we have to address in the next few years. Fundamental issues, the database, collection of recorded empirical data from Central Eastern U.S. Obviously, as you know, there are not many records, so we have to go to the other parts of the world, wherever we can, basically anywhere in a stable continental region. So we have started the database a while ago, before even this project started. We wanted to rush on that one, so there are people who are collecting the records. Then source rupture characterization, like rupture area, moment, and the other things, these are well documented and available. I'm just giving you the headline. Source of site path, basically geometric spreading, Q and other issues, basically. Site effect, linear and nonlinear site response is very important. Constraint on attenuation models based on MMI and liquefaction distribution in the previous earthquake, just to make sure what we predict is not compatible with real world. And ground motion simulation is important, obviously, for this project because we are not going to have so many recorded data for Central Eastern U.S., so we have to rely heavily on simulation, but we have to use calibrated and validated simulated ground motion for this project. And then attenuation models, ground motion prediction equations, basically. The goal is to develop the models for magnitude 4 to 8, distance of 0 to 1,000 kilometers. Originally, we had it 500 kilometers. USGS, who is one of the final users of this project for national hazard maps, they requested that we go all the way to 1,000 kilometers. Horizontal ground motion for sure, and we have to do something regarding vertical ground motion. Also, 5% damp linear elastic response to spectrum from 0.01 to 10 seconds, consistent with NGA West project that we finished, and develop uncertainty model also. Then the final phase of this program, or the final task of this program after we have the models and so on, is to develop epistemic uncertainty and weighting for different models. Project schedule is that we have to finish the final product completed by the models by September 30, 2013. Then there is a 1 year between October 1, 2013 and September 30, 2014 that we collect and comments and reviews, especially from USGS for national hazard maps and so on. But the models, including internal review, all the QA and checking and so on, have to be finished by September 30, 2013. And the end is September 30th, 2014 is the end of the project. So we cannot shift these things. We have to really press everything to deliver everything on time. The full transparency is really the heart of this project. It's similar to NGA West that we did. This is a photo of NGA West project that we had. We had many workshops in the NGA West. You ain't seen nothing. We are going to have many, many more workshops and public workshop for this project also. It's fully transparent. We are going to have researchers, developers, model developers, end users, funding agencies, all involved in multidisciplinary, very fully transparent program. The database will be fully available to public. Basically, all the background information, reports, supporting research projects, and so on will be available to the public. The project also has been designated as SHAC Level 3 project. It's a very complicated and comprehensive program to make sure that we are fully transparent, everything is checked, all the new and old ideas are heard in the program. Definitely it guarantees the high quality of the project for and is consistent with the other projects that NRC, DOE and EPRI have. There are lots of documents and related duties. These are posted at peer website to get background of the process and procedures. I think Annie may mention these things in her presentation. Organization of the project, basically, obviously you cannot see these things. That was not intentional. I want to show you the global. There is a management system on top, and then there are lots of working groups. I'm going to just show quickly the thing. The key of these things is a joint management committee. This is JMC, Joint Management Committee. It works very well through Peer Lifelines program. In the last 12 years, we learned it works very well. Basically, representatives of funding agency, in this case, representative of NRC, USGS, EPRI, and DOE, and peer community, basically, are part of this JMC, Joint Management Committee. JMC has to sign and approve all sub-awards. We cannot just go and spend money on a single individual or a group and so on. We cannot do that. We have to get blessing of all these. And the approval has to be unanimous. It's not like that someone from peer or someone from DOE and so on just decide and give a contract. We cannot do that. The good thing is that so we get the consensus. So whatever unanimous consensus among all the people here, then we can have sub-awards. Then we have a technical review committee. Don't worry about the names, but the concept. There is a technical review committee that is going to review all major proposals in terms of dollar amount, in terms of a schedule, in terms of a scope, and so on. And then we have a bunch of working groups. Database working group started about a year ago. It started even before the project started. Basically, their mission is to collect data, empirical data from all stable continental regions. We have a geotechnical working group. Their mission is to have basically linear, nonlinear soil models for the attenuation models as well as other things. We have a simulation working group that started. We have a working group on so-called path, basically geometric spreading and Q and others. And then we are going to have other, in fact, just recently we are going to we decided to have a working group on sigma. This is their meeting of today. So we are going to have more working group. Then there is a SHAC component of these things that maybe Annie is going to talk about. There is a review panel and then technical integrators. Many, many people are involved just to make sure that we are doing something right and with high quality on time. Today's workshop, basically, during the life of NGA East program, we are going to have many public workshops. The purposes of this workshop are to collect feedback from the community, just to make sure that we are not doing something in isolation and something strange. We love to hear feedback from you, and also to let you know what's going on in NGA East. We don't want to do something in back room and then suddenly after 5 years we publish a bunch of papers. That's not the purpose, basically. So we want to tell you what's going on in the NGA East program, and we really like to hear your feedback. Today is the first public workshop that we have in this project. The purpose is to go over various issues on related to uncertainties, both aleatory and epistemic uncertainties issues related to ground motion prediction equations in general, but specifically for Central Eastern U.S. We are going to share you the issues and ideas, finalize the list of action items, and get feedback. But one thing I want to make sure that you know, and I lower your expectation. We don't have the final answer. We don't know really about the answers to all these issues that later on Norm is going to give you the list. We just want to share it with you to make sure that we are not missing any major things, or the plan that we are thinking to do is okay from your perspective. So this is the agenda, basically. After me, 15 minutes, Annie, representative of the NRC Nuclear Regulatory Commission, is going to give the perspective of NRC. Then Larry is going to talk about perspective of the other funding agency, EPRI. And then Professor Julian Balmer from Imperial College in London is going to set the stage about the various terminology, what's going on, the importance of sigma and so on. Then Norm is going to build on top of the previous presentation, more specific about what the issues are for Central Eastern U.S. and what action items we have compiled. And then we have a discussion and then lunch. So without further delay, I'll ask Annie to give NRC perspective on NGA East project.